Father? Why did you marry Mother?
The obvious answer is that we loved each other. Your mother was everything I ever wanted in a woman. I knew I'd be proud to call her my wife. Listen, son. Always follow what your heart tells you to do. It will be the right thing.
Yes.
Oh, oh, just do this. Just press this one.
You're so good.
You should press this first.
Thank you.
Or you can press this. You know, when it comes to computer games, I'm the game master. There's nothing I can beat that.
Can you help me with this?
Here, here, here. Press that. Of course, there. You get it now?
Really?
You see that? Sandy. Sandy, wait, wait. Sandy, wait, hold on. She was just...
Madam, but why are you holding that knife? What are you going
Emma,
to do?
I'm going to kill myself.
What?
I'm going to kill myself.
Oh, madam, please don't kill yourself. Please don't, madam. Sir.
Honey? What is going on?
I'm sorry, husband of mine.
Mother.
I just want to be a good mother to your son. I want to straighten him out, but he's just too stubborn.
Mother.
He does not want to marry the mother of his child.
Mother, please don't do this. This is not necessary.
I promise I will kill myself if you don't marry Daphne.
Mother.
I've done everything for you. I gave you everything because I love you.
Mother.
All these years, this is the only thing I ask of you, but you won't give it to me.
Okay, look, look, Mother.
Oh, honey.
Mother, you don't have to do this. Look, I'll accept responsibility for the child. I'm going to be a good father. But I'm not going to marry Daphne.
Then I will kill myself.
Mother.
Charles, I swear I'm going to kill myself because you won't do it. This is it, then.
Mother.
Goodbye, everyone.
My
Mother,
dear,
please
no.
Do something
no.
About it.
Wait, Charles, do what your mother tells you to do.
But you told me to follow my heart.
If you follow your heart, your mother will kill herself. You obey your mother. Do what she tells you to do.
Hello, Daphne.
Charles.
I have to see you.
Okay. When?
I'm on my way to your place right now.
Why so soon? I mean, is it important?
It's about us.
Okay. See you.
Bye.
Sandy, will you please talk to me? Sandy! Why are you getting jealous now?
I'm not jealous.
Then why did you get angry when you saw me talking to another woman?
I don't know.
What? That's impossible. You don't know why you're angry.
I said I don't know. Now leave. Get out of here. I don't want to talk to you.
Come on, Sandy. I'm sorry. Come on. Talk to me now, please. Sandy! Sandy, will you listen to me? Sandy!
Don't touch me!
I love you. Sandy. I don't know if you're going to believe me, but it's true. I think I really love you. I don't know. I think that's how it is when you're in love. I've never felt this way before. It's like, I want to see you and be with you all the time. But when I'm with you, I can't say anything. But that's really what I wanted to tell you. I love you.
It's love, not lab.
Love, lab. They both mean the same thing, right? I love you. I mean it.
Ma-ning-ning. I knew this is where I'd find you. Good thing you're here. I have to tell you something.
But, Mother, I thought you were mad at me. How come you're so nice to me all of a sudden?
Listen to me. Remember your sister, Mayumi? I think I know where she is.
Oh? But how, Mother?
It's Charles. Charles was able to help me. You know? Our family will be reunited soon. We're going to be together again. What you said was right. That you would take us out of our miserable life here. All this time I kept searching for that one thing that will bring me luck, but it was just right here. And that was you. You're going to bring us a lot of luck. We will be rich.
What?
Ma-ning-ning. Charles wants to marry you.
What are we going to talk about? You have nothing to worry about. You don't need to do anything. I'm going to raise our baby by myself. I'm setting you free.
Daphne. I am going to marry you.
Really? Really, Charles?
Yes.
I promise you won't regret this. I love you so much. I love you so much. Thank you. But, Mother, I'm not in love with Charles.
And so what? He loves you so much.
Mother, I'm not going to marry someone just because of his money.
What? What are you saying? Don't do this to me, Ma-ning-ning. Don't you understand? When we finally reunite with Mayumi, she's not going to leave us anymore. Because we can now give her the good life she's always wanted. Did you think of that? Well? Will you stop committing yourself to that good-for-nothing Eric? He's not worth it. I'm sure he doesn't love you. Where is he now?
I'm sure he's with that other woman.
Why don't you give Charles a chance? I'm begging you. When I married your father back then, I didn't love him. But when he told me that he'd always be there for me, that he'd stay with me forever, and that he'll take care of me, I learned to love him after that. And you know, until now, I don't ever regret making that decision to marry your father, because to this day, I love him very, very much because of what he's done for me. Didn't you promise your father something? You promised him. You promised that you will always take care of all of us. So do this. Fulfill your promise to your father. Here's your chance to make that promise you made to him come true.
Mother? Mother?
Come in. Come in.
Drink your medicine. Mother, stop that. Mother, stop it! I'm marrying Daphne. Okay?
Charles?
Are you happy now?
Charles. Ah.
queen.
No, you're not.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
I'm the queen.
What's going on? Are you all fighting again? You're being so loud over there. What's going on this time,
huh? Mother Cheetah, I keep telling them I'm the queen. But they don't like the
idea. Oh, here's what we'll do. I'll be the queen, you'll be the princess, she'll be your maid, then you'll be her prince, and you'll be the genie. Now you can play. Tell them what to do. You're the princess after all.
All of you, go there.
Oh, you're there, Armand.
And help all those men, all
right? No, we don't want to. We're not your servants.
Why don't you help me out?
Help you with what, Armand?
Well, I'm thinking of doing something for Sandy.
Wow, you're a big boy now, Armand. You're courting a girl now.
What's wrong? It's taking you so long to do something for her, Armand.
Hey, that's not true. It's just that I've been working in the city now. It's far, so it's really tough. But hold on, are you willing to help me?
I don't know. What are we supposed to do here?
Well, here, take this. Take these gifts. Then I want you to deliver one gift in front of my house for Sandy to see. Do it once every day, okay? Is that clear? Okay?
Is that all?
Yes, that's it.
What's in it for us?
Right.
Oh, that. Okay. Okay, when I get back from the city, I'll treat you to a snack. Is that a deal?
Oh, really?
I promise. Well, are you game? Come on, say yes.
All right, we'll do it.
Fine.
Okay.
Fine, we'll do it.
Okay, yeah,
hey,
let's
Ning.
Do it.
Hey, stop being so noisy, these
right.
kids.
Don't you want to join them, Ning?
Okay, on the first day, this one's mine.
That is mine.
Wait a minute. What did you ever do to this poor child? Why is she so scared of you?
I'm wondering about that myself. Ning, why are you so scared of me?
Bam! He killed my father!
Stop crying, Armand. I think you better go now. The kid
my
won't stop crying.
Dead.
Oh, come on. That's
my
enough. That's enough. Stop
dead.
Crying. Go on. You have to leave now. Go on.
All right.
Just leave, Armand.
You're only here for a few days, and still you're met with problems.
It seems that all we have here are problems. It's weighing me down.
Well, you know, these problems are like baggage. The longer you carry them, the heavier they get. Why don't you let some of them go instead? Or leave some of them here and deal with them? You shouldn't take them with you all the time.
Well, I have a lot of problems wherever I go. I'll have more problems when I work in the city. Then my mother added more today.
She did? Well, what did she tell you about this time? I thought she wasn't speaking to you.
Well, yes, but then she came over earlier. She wanted to talk.
Well, are you okay now?
Things got more complicated. The thing is, Myrna, she told me she wants me to accept Charles's proposal.
Oh, you can't do that.
You really can't do that, Mining Ning. You're my lady.
Brian, it's getting late. Why don't you go upstairs? Go on, we're going to talk. Go, go, it's bedtime.
Okay.
Mining Ning, it's impossible. Earlier today, I just heard that Charles will be marrying Daphne.
Mining Ning!
What now? Have you forgotten what I told you? Didn't I tell you to stop bothering me?
This won't take too long. I just wanted to talk to you about something.
What for? When she finds out, Daphne will get mad. And I just found out. I heard you two are going to get married soon.
Mining Ning, I really don't love her. It's you. I love you. And you're the one I want to marry.
Goodness, Charles, please. Stop it. You're going to be married to Daphne. You two are going to have a child. So do me a favor, stop following me around. It's not right for you to fall in love with me.
I will leave Daphne just to be with you.
Stop it, Charles. Will you snap out of it, please? You're going crazy. You're going to have a baby. You have to marry her. You don't have a choice. Be a man about it.
Thank you.
Daphne, my child, you can't seem to wipe that smile off your face. What's going on?
Are you sick, my dear granddaughter?
No, grandmother.
Then what?
I just want everything to be perfect. This is the happiest day of my life.
Mother, wow. Don't spoil it for her. Come on, Daphne, share it with us.
Okay. Grandmother, father, of course, mother. Charles and I are finally engaged. Finally!
Oh, wow, that's great!
Yes, I know!
Oh, that's nice. I'm happy for you.
Thank you.
Okay, that's good. Oh, but where is the ring?
It's on its way, Grandmother. I'm sure Charles is just picking out the perfect engagement ring for us. I'm so happy. It's just like magic.
Yes, really. I'll drink to that.
Go get some rice.
Surprise!
What's that?
For your future. Since you wouldn't accept the money that I wanted to lend you, I decided to buy these books for you instead.
How many times do I have to tell you I don't want or need your help?
And how many times do I have to tell you that I'm not doing this out of charity? You're going to pay me back. What did you think? Just because you're cute and hot doesn't mean I'm going to give you these things. Go on. Just take it, come on. We both know that this is the only way for you to study and finally finish that law degree of yours. Bye.
Mother Cheetah, what are we doing in this place?
Didn't I tell you? We were going to help for Inang. I really feel that she's like this because something really bad happened to her, see? She needs help. Oh, hey, excuse me, sir.
Yes,
can you just help
it?
Us out? This won't take long. The thing is, I want to report an incident. It's this little girl. I really feel that something bad happened to her. That's why she's like this for all the time. She cries a lot. She's always scared. She doesn't speak. You think you can help us?
Can you tell me what your name is?
Go and answer the good man's question. Whatever he asks you, just answer it. This good man will be able to help you. Go on, don't be scared.
Julie Esteban, sir.
Julie, is there anything you want to tell me?
Someone killed my father.
Who killed your father, Julie?
Go tell him, Inang. Tell him what happened. He's going to help us out. He will.
A policeman.
Policeman?
Slap all the handcuffs. Quickly. The handcuffs. Quick. Hurry. Let go of me.
What? Policeman? But who?
You are something else, kid. Who would have thought that you'd go against your own best friend?
Well, I like this job, sir.
If that's how tough you can be, then you'll go far in this business. You go and stay low for now. I'm sure the police are looking all over for you. If something happens to Octopus, you'll be the first to get arrested by the police. We can't take that chance. You might give us away.
Oh, no, sir. I wouldn't do that to you.
Here's what you should do. Now, do not go ahead for the kill. You have to break him down before you kill him. You don't seem to understand. I'll tell you. Here's what you do.
You being a new guy, you just have to listen.
You look for that one person that is very important to Octopus. He has a brother, right? Befriend him. Give that boy a job, anything. And when you have his loyalty, that's when you strike to bring Octopus down.
Oh, Pusit, you mean?
You have to know the personalities behind
the... Well, the thing is, sir... Maybe we can just forget about all that happened with Octopus.
Don't worry about it.
I'm pretty sure he's scared about it now. I know what a coward he is.
Maybe you're the one being a coward now.
Our other hideout on the other side of town.
Just do what I tell you to do. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes.
can't believe my son is studying. Attorney Eric Fergante. It's a good thing you're studying now. That you're not out drinking again.
Well, I have to do really well with this. I don't want to waste all the money we've spent on tuition.
Well, that's good to hear. But those books look really expensive. Good thing you earned enough.
The thing is, somebody was nice enough to help me out.
Oh, I didn't know there were still people who would be that nice. Do I know this person?
It's Lilibeth.
Oh, Eric. Haven't you learned anything? You know that woman only wants one thing from you.
Mother, I needed her help so I could pay for these books for school.
Oh, no, Eric. I don't want you asking that girl for any more help.
But, Mother, I just asked her for some money. I'll be paying her back anyway.
Pay her back? With what? The minute I saw that woman, I already knew what she wanted. She'll bring nothing but trouble. I don't want you asking her for any help ever again.
Hi, Beret family.
Hello.
Welcome.
Welcome.
Please come in. Please come
Hi.
In.
Come
Hello.
In.
Come in. Come in, please.
Oh, this is my husband, Pierre.
How are you doing?
And my son, Charles.
Hello.
And this is Eleanor.
Yes.
Pierre.
Yes, this is my
Pierre.
Husband, Sigmund.
Hello,
and
Sigmund.
That's my mother-in-law.
Oh, yes.
Hello.
Put it there, please.
Hello.
This is for you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you so
how
much.
How was your trip?
So, how was the
okay.
trip?
It was a long drive, but it's okay for the happiness of the children. Right, Charles?
Charles.
Oh. Oh. Yes, whatever that was.
Oh, Charles, you surely made the right decision by marrying my granddaughter.
And I hope you won't disappoint us.
Of course not. My son is very much in love with your daughter. Isn't that so, Charles?
Yes, Mother.
Well, that's good. Let's plan the wedding. Come on, sit down, sit down.
Okay,
sit
down.
Wedding Ning, please,
you
will you take
down.
This inside? Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, so what shall we do? What do you want? What color do you want, Daphne? Anything, Charles? Any preference?
Color?
Yes, color for the wedding.
Pink.
Pink.
Pink is good.
Good choice.
Daphne, pink? You like pink?
Habaga?
I'll be leaving soon. I'll be going to the city now. I have to go and check out Mayumi's address at the statistics office, so you have to stay here while I'm gone. Okay?
I wonder how Mayumi's going to react when she sees you again. Will she move back here?
Well, of course. I don't think I'm going to come back here without your sister Mayumi. She has to come back.
And what about Manning Ning? Will you let her come back?
Of course. She'll come home. Things are looking good for us, huh?
All right. Mother, you take care, okay?
Okay. Watch the house, okay?
Manning Ning?
Charles, what are you doing here? You have to go. Daphne might think I'm up to something.
I don't care.
Well, tough luck. I care about this job. A lot of people are depending on the money I earn here, so will you please?
Is that the only thing that's holding you back? Manning Ning, I can take you away from here. You can forget about your problems. Just say that you love me. Manning Ning, just tell me before it's too late, and I promise you, your life will be better.
I knew I'd find you here. How
Daphne,
dare you do this to me? Why would you just leave me alone? Let us be.
Let me go!
She said let me go!
Daphne, that's enough.
I can't stay here. I don't think I can take any more of Daphne. No matter what I do, she really finds a way to hate me and hurt me.
Think about it. Maybe you can stay, Manning Ning. I don't know what I would do without you. You're like a granddaughter to me. I hope you treat me like your own grandmother as well.
Ningning, I'm so sorry for everything that happened here. It won't happen again. Nobody in this house can ever hurt you while I'm still around. Please stay for my mother.
Yes, Ningning, we will be very grateful if you stay. If you don't leave us, please, please do this for me. I'm getting old. I've never asked for anything. I really need you here with me.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Come on. I have a big surprise for you. Sorry, I'm getting so nervous. It's just that this is really important to me.
Yes, it really looks like this is very important. I wonder why.
This is the most important day of my life. Oh. Excuse me. Hello?
Hello, Aureliano.
The chief wants you to report back here.
I have to go now?
Yes.
What's this about?
Aureliano, he just asked for you. It's important.
Just get back here.
Okay, I'll be there.
Okay.
Here you go. Let me see.
Puss it.
Here.
Hey, come here.
This is for you.
So it's you. I'll beat you up. Why did you get into a fight with my brother, huh?
What do you want?
Hey, don't get mad. Take it easy. Peace, man. You know I'm scared of you. I'm scared. Don't get mad at me. I wanted to talk to you because... Here. I have some leftover snacks for you. Here, it's all yours. Take it. You like that? Try it. Try it with this. It's good. Here's more. You might get thirsty, so... Here, get a drink. Here. Are we okay?
You want one more?
Are you okay now?
Give me some more.
I'll give you more, but you have to do something for me.
What is it?
Hold on. Wait a minute. Do you see him? At the corner? That's Uste. That's him. That's Uste. Go there and give this to him. Then he's going to give you some money, huh? When he gives that to you, leave right away. Bring the money to me. Then I'll give you more snacks.
That's it?
Yes. I'll give you a lot. And I'll give you some money. What do you say?
All right, I'll take this. I'll go ahead.
Wait a minute. Don't be in such a hurry. Take your time. Don't go running off right away. Don't forget, though, this is our secret. Mm-hmm. Nobody can ever find out about this. Especially not Octopus. Understand?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Get it?
Got it.
Okay, go. Go.
Buddy, thank you, thank you, thank you. And I'm sure I'm not the only one who will say this. I'm pretty sure that all the girls in the shop will be more than happy to give you a kiss or more. They'll line up just for you, one by one.
Oh, no need for that. I'm okay.
What?
I did it for the shop, that's it.
Is that true? Hold on. Are you okay, man?
What do you mean?
You could be sick or something. You're getting a free kiss, a free hug, but you're saying no? That's not the habagat I know. What's going on? What is it?
What?
What is it?
What?
I could smell something. Is that love in the air?
You just farted.
Tell me, you're in love, right? Right? Tell me.
I don't know. I know this girl, she's different. I really feel like I hit the jackpot this time. You know? I found this girl who's so beautiful. So fair. And so caring. She's everything I want and more, I'm telling you.
I won't let her go.
No wonder you're going nuts. And you're hardly around for the work we do for Mr. Harry. Who is she?
Wait a minute. What happened between you and Bukol? I heard you had a big fight by the port. We're all friends here. We shouldn't fight at all, Octopus.
That's nothing. I've decided to just forget about it. But he shouldn't. mess with me again, or else... I don't know what I'd do. I can kill him, you know.
You wouldn't do that.
But wait, who is she? Who is this girl you're falling for? Beautiful, fair, and sweet? I know a lot of yes. Beautiful, fair, and sweet women.
She's so caring.
Oh.
Very right. Loving.
Maning Ning, please take good care of Mother, okay? Don't forget her medicine. Give them to her.
Yes, sir. Take care.
Bye.
Maning Ning?
Huh?
Maning Ning?
Mother.
What are you doing here?
Mother, this is where I work.
What? This cannot be. Come with me. You're coming back with me.
Mother, I can't leave this place. Not now.
And why not?
Mother, if I could only go and leave this place, I really would. But I can't do that. I just can't. And I can't tell you
what?
My reasons.
Why can't you tell me? Who's stopping you? That man I just saw? And why do you have bruises? Is that man hurting you?
Mother, no. They all treat me really well in this house. I'm okay.
And you're defending him? You don't know who they are, Maning Ning. You're coming with me. We're going home right now.
Mother, I really can't leave. I'm not defending them at all. What's going on, Mother? Do you know who that man is? Why won't you tell me what's going on?
If you don't want to come home with me, then fine. I hope you're happy with what you're doing. I hope you get what you deserve.
Hey, why do you look so sad?
It's just that I'm really, really hungry. Armin promised me that he'll treat me to dinner, but he couldn't. He had to go to the precinct.
Let's go.
Go where? Where are we going?
Let's buy some food at the store. Then we can go to the computer shop. My treat. Come on.
All right.
Virgie, how could you throw a fit like that in front of Maning Ning?
What can I do? What if she finds out that Sigmund is her real father?
Will you use her head? If you keep causing trouble like that, she might suspect something. Huh? Why won't you just let her work for Sigmund? You should be thankful that you and him haven't met. That would be such a big mess. Here's what we're going to do. Just let Maning Ning stay and work for that animal Sigmund.
Somebody told me that you and your mother had a fight here. She came to see you here?
Oh, I'm sorry about that, Madame Consuelo. I didn't mean to cause a lot of trouble and scandal here in your house.
Oh, don't worry about that. I'm actually worried about you. What really happened?
My mother got so mad when she found out that I'm working for you in this house. She wanted me to leave and go with her.
Maybe she heard of how my granddaughter and her mother are treating you. Don't worry, Maning Ning. I'm going to go and talk to your mother, okay? To assure her that Sigmund and myself are always here to make sure that you're protected.
Oh, you don't have to do that, Madame Consuelo. Because I don't think that's the reason.
What?
My mother got so angry. But the thing is, she won't tell me what it is. She doesn't want me to know what's really going on. She just told me that I shouldn't be working here.
Oh. I wonder what that is. Could we have done something wrong to her that we didn't know about?
Oh, don't worry about that. I just think that she still hasn't forgiven me. She's been really angry at me because I lied to her for years that I was studying. Don't worry about it.
Okay.
You have to get ready, Aureliano. We have a very big problem. Do you still remember Boy Bato? That pusher that was killed at the fish port? A case was filed. It's with the higher-ups. It seems that Boy Bato's daughter was there when you killed her father. So, I'm just waiting for orders from my boss on what you should do.
You know, it's true what they say. The more you hate, the more you love.
Why? Were you really that angry with me before?
Not really. I was just mad. But what's important now is we're together.
Ouch! What are you doing? That's my hair!
Oh, was that your hair? I thought it was just noodles.
Hey, stop it. We're not that close yet, you know.
Well, what can I do? Your hair really looks much like these noodles. Well. Hey, I was just kidding. Why are you frowning at me again? Hey. Come on. Here's your drink. Have a soda, some crackers. Hey, come on. Hey. I'm sorry. It was just a joke, I'm sorry. Sandy. Joke. It was just a joke.
You know, you're always apologizing, but you're always hurting me.
Sandy, I just don't know how to talk to you. You look so beautiful. I get scared. Don't get mad. I really like you. Sandy, I'm sorry. Here, I promise you that. This is going to be my last apology. I won't do anything ever again that's going to hurt you or cause you to get mad at me. Okay? I promise that. I love you so much. I'm sorry, Sandy. I didn't mean it.
I think I have to go.
Oh, wait a minute. Sandy, I really think it's time that we talk to Armand and tell him that we're together.
What?
I really have this feeling that he's falling in love with you too.
What? But I treat Armand like a brother.
What kind of brother showers you with gifts and gives you everything you want? Whether he's in love with you or not, I really think we have to tell him the truth. Armand is my friend, and I don't want to keep him hoping. I don't want him to get hurt.
Why is your mother like that? You know, when I saw her shouting at you like that, I realized that my life is much better than yours, because I don't have a mother who treats me that way.
I don't care what my mother does to me. No matter what she does, I still love her, and I don't think I can ever have the courage to leave her.
Well, if that's what you want to do with your life, that's fine. But please don't cause your trouble here. I don't want your mother coming to this house. This is an exclusive village. You shouldn't be causing trouble here.
Daphne, that's enough.
Mother, why are you taking that lowly maid's side? Daphne's right, that Meningning causes so much trouble here.
Actually, you two are the ones causing so much trouble. Meningning's mother is more than welcome to come to my house. In fact, I want to get to know her better. And I want her to know that I treat Meningning as my own granddaughter, as part of this family. And that way, her mother won't have to worry. She will feel that her daughter is safe here when she's here working for me. Now, if that's a problem with you, Eleanor, You can leave my house.
Let's go.
There he is. I'm so sorry about that, Aureliano. You know, I have a family. I have 10 kids and 3 wives. Nobody's life would get affected if you go to jail. So don't involve us in this.
Remember this, Aureliano. You are the only one the child recognized. If you drag us down with you, I'll hunt you down. Keep that in mind.
You. I'll get you.
You know it's not safe to travel this late.
I couldn't spend another night at my employer's house, Myrna.
What? Why do you have so many scratches, Maningning? What are they doing to you over there? Do they hurt you? Do they beat you up? Maningning, why haven't you told me about this? Didn't I already tell you? You shouldn't keep your problems to yourself. I'm always here for you. Your friends are here for you. Does your mother know what's happening?
Oh, Myrna, if my mother only knew. If she only knew that I'm doing all this for her, that I haven't left that place because of her, because I need to work to pay off her debts.
What debts are you talking about this time, huh?
Nothing.
Maningning, why can't you just go and talk to your mother? You know, mothers, they're just like ice. They're really tough, but their hearts melt when their children are concerned, you know?
No, she might get mad at me more. It will make things worse. She'll throw another fit when she finds out I'm working there.
Why don't you just stay here to rest?
Oh, no, thank you. I'll be going now.
What?
Maningning.
This is what I was afraid of. My real mother tracked me down, Mother.
Goodness, Daphne. You know what you should do? You should sit down right beside me, relax, and put night cream on your face.
Mother, stop it. I'm really scared about this.
What are you afraid of? Those lowly people? Daphne, don't worry. Your mother can never enter into this house of ours. I will be the one to meet her, and I will personally drag her outside where she belongs. So, would you please relax and don't be afraid of anything, okay? You know, it's that fear of yours that will get you into trouble.
I think I'm really scared because of what I did to them, because I really owe them a lot. I left my own family behind. Maybe that's why I'm unlucky when it comes to love. Maybe that's why Charles doesn't love me. That is my punishment.
Daphne, you have to snap out of it. You might be forgetting the reason why you came here when you were a little girl. Remember, you didn't want to grow up smelling like fish. It wasn't your fault. I mean, I wouldn't want to be where you were. And if you don't compose yourself, both of us will be in trouble.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now, let's put night cream on your face.
Mother.
Come on, come on. There you go.
You know what? You two should talk. I'll go and leave you alone.
Eric. I don't think I can do this by myself. Why did you have to leave me when I really need you with me right now?
I will never leave your side. I'm always here for you. I know that you've decided to keep me out of your life. But I promise. I promise you. The minute you open up your heart again for me, I'll just be here waiting for you. Okay? Come here.